Hello everyone. In today's class, we are going to learn about geometry mathematics. So about geometry chapter, we are going to learn. So first point. A point in geometry is a location. It has no size, that is no width, no length and no depth. A point is shown by a dot. Point is denoted by letter O. So a small dot, or else you can say a small dot made with a sharp pencil is so called point. So normally point is we will represent by the letter alphabet O. Line. A line is a collection of points. It has no end points and extends endlessly in both the directions. It does not have a definite length. So a line means a collection of points, and it will not be having any, it extends in endlessly in both the direction, either this side or this side, but it will not be having any fixed length. So this is about line. Next, line segment. A straight path between two end points. It has a beginning and an ending point. It has a definite length. So line segment means, so it will be having both beginning and ending, and it will be having a fixed length also. So this is line segment. Next is ray. A part of line that extends endlessly in one direction only. It has a starting point but no end. It has a starting point but no ending point. It does not have a definite length. So ray means, so what it will be means, just it will be having the starting point, but in any direction it can go. So it don't have any ending point. So for this you can say the best example, from the sun. So sun is a fixed point. So from the sun rays we get, so in different directions we get. So there will be no end for the rays. Then you can say from the torchlight also, what we get the light, that is also a best example for the rays. So next is angle. When two rays meet at a point, a ray is formed. It is marked by a small curve. So that means here you can see, here this is one ray and this is one ray. So when these two rays meet, so we will get one angle here. So this is so like this. We will mark with a small curve. So here angle will form. So the point where the two rays meet is called the vertex. So here these two rays will meet, and this meeting point we will say vertex. The rays form the arms of the angle, and here whatever the rays, it is called arms of the angle. Next is types of angles. Zero angle. An angle measuring 0 degrees. So zero angle means always it measures 0 degrees. Next is acute angle. An angle that measures less than 90 degrees and greater than 0 degrees. So that means 0 to 90 degrees in between. So what the angles will measure, that is called acute angle. Next is obtuse angle. An angle that measures less than 180 degrees and greater than 90 degrees. So obtuse angle means always it measures greater than 90 degrees. So that means 90 to 180 degrees in between it will be. So that is obtuse angle. Right angle. So right angle means we know that, so exactly it measures 90 degrees only, and it will be in the L shape. Next, straight angle. An angle that measures exactly 180 degrees. So this straight angle also, it measures 180 degrees exactly. So this is straight angle. Reflex angle. An angle that measures less than 360 degrees and greater than 180 degrees. So reflex angle means this is in between 180 degrees and 360 degrees. In between what the angle will measure, so that is called reflex angle. Next, complete angle. An angle that measures exactly 360 degrees. So the angle which will be measured is exactly 360 degrees, that is called complete angle. So these are the types of angles. See here. So this is zero angle. So examples of types of angles. This is zero angle. So it measures exactly 0 degrees. Acute angle. So that means less than 90 degrees. So this is the acute angle. Obtuse angle. Greater than 90 degrees and 90 to 180 degrees between. So this is obtuse angle. Right angle. Exactly it measures 90 degrees. So this is right angle. Next, right angle. So this right angle means it measures 180 degrees. So here we will get 180 degrees measurement. Reflex angle. This is in between 180 and 360 degrees in between. So this is the example for reflex angle. And complete angle. Complete angle, this is exactly, it measures 360 degrees. So these are the examples for types of angles. Next, measuring angle. So now we have learned types of angles, but how to measure the angle? The standard unit for measuring an angle is the degree. The mathematical symbol for degree or degree is so small, like zero we will write. So normally the standard to measure an angle, that is unit is degree. To measure an angle in degree, we use a protractor. You will find it in your geometry box. So what means, so this how we will measure the angle means by using protractor. So that protractor we will get in our geometry box. The protractor has two scales on it, an inner circle and an outer scale of number beginning from 0 and going up to 180. So this protractor, it will be having two scales. So one, it will be inside scale, that also it will be having 0 to 180 degrees, and outside also it will be having, that is also 0 to 180 degrees it will be. Next, the protractor can therefore be read from left to right or right to left. It also has a center and baseline joining the center to 0 degrees. So drawing angles. So you can draw an angle of given measuring using protractor. So this is called protractor, and we have learned two scales. See here, you can see this 0 to 180 degrees. This is the inner scale. And again outside from here, you have, can see from 0 to again you have here 180 degrees. So this is called outer scale and this is called inner scale. And here you can see this is the base and here this is the center. So now we have learned. And here they have given, so now by using this protractor, how we can draw the angle. So here you can see this is the 70 degrees they have given. Now how you have to draw the 70 degrees. So first draw a ray AB. So that means here you can see in this diagram. So here first you have to draw one line like this AB. Now, place the base line of the protractor on ray AB with its center on A. So now here, this is there. Now this base, you have to keep it here. And this center, exactly, you should keep it on the point, near the point A. Next, note that AB meets the 0 degrees point on the baseline along the inner circle. So now here, inner circle it is there, no? So this base, this A point, it should meet like this 0 degrees. So here you can see. So like this. Now what you should do? Locate the 70 degrees mark on the inner scale and mark it with a dot C. So now here, so from 0 degrees you can see 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70. So now here 70 degrees we got here. So now what we have to do, exactly near to the 70 degrees, just you can with the pencil, just you can keep one dot and you can mark as C. So after that you can remove the protractor and just you can join this line. See, remove the protractor and draw the ray AC. So now you should remove and this AC you have to meet. And now you, here you can see angle BAC equals to 70 degrees. So this is the way by using protractor finding the angle. So next is types of lines. Intersecting lines. Two lines intersect at a point and the lines that intersect are called intersecting lines. See what means here, two lines where they meet. So this meeting point is called intersecting. So or else where the two rays meet, where the two rays intersect. Intersect is nothing but meeting. So now here you can see this blue line and red line. These two are two lines. And these two lines, they meet in the middle. So here this is the point. And this one you can say intersection. So this means these are called intersecting lines. Next is perpendicular lines. When two lines intersect and make a right angle, then they are said to be perpendicular to each other. See now here, two lines intersect. So that means just now we have learned, and like this two lines are intersecting. When they intersect and here they should form right angle. So where it forms right angle, that is called perpendicular to each other. Suppose here now you can say this AB and this is CD. Now you can say AB line is perpendicular to CD. So where the two lines intersect and intersect, that is called intersecting lines. And where they intersect, there they should form a right angle. That means exactly 90 degrees it should measure. So that is called perpendicular lines. Next, set squares. Set squares, open your geometry box. Other than a ruler and a protractor, what does it contain? So normally in our geometry box, you will be having like a scale, protractor or a compass, all that you will be having. So there are two triangular objects. There are two triangular objects. These are called set squares. See in your geometry box like this. So these you will get. So these are called set squares. Trace their shapes and measure the angles. Next, you see parallel lines. Two lines are parallel if they do not intersect each other and contain the same length. So what is parallel lines means they should be equal in the length and it should not intersect at any point. So if you extend also it will be going only, but it will not it should not intersect in anywhere. So these type of lines are called parallel lines. Next is polygons. A closed shape with any number of straight sides is a polygon. A closed shape with any number of straight sides is a polygon. So the diagram means it should be closed figure and it should have straight sides. Next, three-sided polygon is called triangle. See a three-sided polygon. So this you can see. So this is, so from here to here one side and here to here one side and here to here one side. So this three-sided polygon is called triangle. Tri means three. A triangle has three sides, three angles and three vertices. Next, four-sided polygon is a quadrilateral. See now here, four sides. So this is called quadrilateral. Quad means four. Next, a quadrilateral has four sides, four angles and four vertices. So here you can see these have four sides. AB one side, BC one side and CD one side and AD is one side. So here near A one angle, near B one angle and near C one angle and near D one angle. So there will be four angles and vertices A, B, C, D. These are the four vertices and these are polygons. Next, types of quadrilaterals. Rectangle. All angles are right angles. Opposite sides are parallel, opposite sides are equal. So rectangle also is a quadrilateral. See here in rectangle you can see. So all angles are right angles. See here you can see all it will be right angles. And here opposite sides are equal. So here in this opposite sides are equal and opposite sides are parallel also. Next is square. All angles are right angles. Opposite sides are parallel. All sides are equal. So you can see in square also. So all the sides are equal in this. And opposite sides are here parallel. And all sides will be equal. Next is parallelogram. Opposite sides are parallel. Opposite sides are equal. So in parallelogram, opposite sides are parallel and opposite sides are equal also. Rhombus. Opposite sides are parallel. All sides are equal. So rhombus, this is rhombus and this is like nothing but square only. Here also all the sides are parallel and all sides are equal in this. Next, properties of triangle. A triangle has three sides and three angles. So we know that a triangle will be having three sides and three angles. The sum of the angles of triangle is always 180 degrees. So in a triangle, all the sum of the three angles should be 180 degrees. Next, the exterior angles of triangle always add up to 360 degrees. Exterior angles means outside angles. It should be 360 degrees up to. The sum of consecutive interior and exterior angle is supplementary. So this you can learn in the higher classes. The sum of lengths of any two sides of a triangle is greater than the length of the third side. Similarly, the difference between the lengths of the any two sides of a triangle is less than the length of the third side. The shortest side is always opposite to the smallest interior angle. Similarly, the longest side is always opposite the largest interior angle. So next is circle. A circle is a closed figure, but it is not bounded by straight line segments. It is bounded by a curved line. So you know that circle means it is a closed figure and but it is not bounded with any straight sides. So it is in round shape. These are curved lines. These are called circle. So this is about circle. So next, center of a circle. The center of a circle is the center point in a circle from which all the distance to the points on the circle are equal. This distance is called the radius of circle. So circle means when you draw by using compass, so one dot, one in the center you will get. So this is called center of the circle. Diameter of a circle. The distance from one point on a circle through the center to another point on the circle. It is also the longest distance across the circle. So diameter means what? Simply you can say that the line which passes through the center, this is called diameter, and this is the longest distance in this circle also. So simply you can say the line which passes through the center of the circle is called diameter. Next, radius of a circle. A line segment connecting the center of a circle to any point on the circle itself. Radius is half of the diameter. So now this is the center, and see here, from center to anywhere you can draw one line, and just it will be in diameter. Diameter means from here through the center, if it passes, then it is called diameter, and in the diameter the radius will be only half. So this is called radius. Next, circumference of a circle. The perimeter of the circle is called circumference. So that means the area, so surrounded fully, so the circle it is, you know, so this round fully. So the perimeter of the circle is called circumference. Next, arc. A part of a curve, especially a part of the circumference of a circle. So arc means from here to, suppose from here to here if you draw. So now you can see here AB. So this is the arc. Semicircle. Half of a circle is called semicircle. So in circle half, so that is called semicircle. Next, finding circumference. If you measure the circumference very accurately, you will find that in every case, circumference by diameter equals to 3.14 or 22/7. This is the constant value. This makes it much easier to find the circumference of a circle. Measure the diameter of the circle and multiply it by 3.14 or 22/7 to get the circumference. So what we have to do means you can take 3.14 or 22/7 to find the circumference. Let us see the example sum. The diameter of a circle is 5 cm. Find its circumference. So here they have given diameter of circle. So we should find the circumference. So circumference means what? Means diameter into circumference. That means 5. Here they have given 5. 5 into, so we should take 3.14. So 5 into 3.14, if you multiply, you will get 15.7 centimeters. Next, example 2. The radius of circle is 6 cm. Find its circumference. Circumference equals to diameter into 3.14. So diameter means we know that, so 2 into radius. 2 into radius into 3.14. So 2 into, so radius here they have given 6. So 2 into 6 into 3.14 centimeters. So we will get 37.68 centimeter. So next, example 3. Find the diameter and radius of circle with circumference 6.28 centimeter. So now here circumference they have given. We have to find diameter and radius. Diameter equal to circumference divided by 3.14. 6.28 by 3.14 centimeter. So when you divide, you will get 2 centimeter answer. So radius equals to 1 by 2 into diameter. So 1 by 2 into 2. So 2 will get cancelled. So we will get 1 centimeter. So this is the way finding circumference. So I hope you understood in this lesson what we have learned. Thank you.